All of you are welcome to this lecture for numerical methods and its applications. In previous lecture, we have taken the Newton's forward interpolation formula and Newton's backward difference interpolation formula. That formula was for the values of x which are equally spaced, means the difference between two consecutive values of x is constant throughout the values of x. Now, if we are given some function y is equal to fx and the values of x are not equally spaced. Suppose there are n plus 1 values of x starting from x0, x1, x2 up to xn. Then from the function y equal to f of x, we get corresponding n plus 1 values of y. If we are using the value of x in the function y equal to f x, then simultaneously we get all the values of y, that are y0, y1, y2 up to yn. Hence we have n plus 1 points, that points lies on the graph y is equal to fx, or the graph of the function y equal to fx passing through the n plus 1 points, namely x0, y0, x1, y1 up to xn, yn, where the values of x are not necessarily equally spaced. Then we have a formula to interpolate the polynomial. We have a formula that is called Lagrange's interpolation formula. Now we prove that formula. Let y equal to fx be a function if x0, x1, xn are the values of x not necessarily equally spaced. Also remember that fx function is a continuous function. Continuous function on the set of n plus 1 points that are given by x0, y0, x1, y1 to xn1. These values are not equally spaced, then corresponding values of y are y0, y1 up to yn. Hence, we have set of n plus 1 points x0, y0, x1, y1 up to xn, yn are the n plus 1 points through which the function the graph of the function y equal to f of x is passing. Hence we have a polynomial y equal to f of x is equal to a0 into x minus x1, x minus x2, x minus xn plus a1 into x minus x0, x minus x2 up to x minus xn plus last term of this polynomial is an into x minus x0, x minus x1 up to x minus xn minus 1. We have this polynomial function. Each term of this polynomial is a product of n brackets, and there are some coefficients for each term. The coefficients are a0, a1, a2 up to an respectively. As graph of this function passing through this n plus 1 points, we can determine the values of constants occurring in this polynomial or occurring in this function by using x is equal to x0, x is equal to x1, x is equal to xn in this expression. As this is the graph of the function passing through this n plus 1 points, we can find the values of the constant coefficients a0, a1 up to an by replacing x by x0, x by x1 up to x by xn, since graph of this function passing through these points. Call this equation number first. Put x is equal to x0 in equation number 1. What we get? Y is equal to f of x0. Y is equal to f of x0 is equal to. But what is f of x0? F of x0 is y0. What is the function? Y equal to f of x. If we use the value of x as x0, we get the value of y as f of x0. And f of x0 is the image of x0 under the function here, that is y0. Hence we write here y0 is equal to f of x0. Now use x is equal to x0 in this equation number first. But if we put x is equal to x0 in this equation number 1, see the second term, third term and up to last term of this function f of x includes the bracket x minus x0. Hence if we put x is equal to x0 in this equation number first, only the first term will not be equal to 0 and other terms starting from second to last all are 0, because all that terms contains the bracket x minus x0 in the product form. Hence y0 equal to f of x0 gives only the value named by as a0 into x0 minus x1, x0 minus x2 up to x0 minus xn, and all next terms starting from second to n plus 1th term are 0. We want the value of constant terms that are a0, a1 up to an. How do we get the constant from this expression? a0 equal to f of x0 upon the product of n brackets x0 minus x1 into x0 minus x2 up to x0 minus xn. Now we put x equal to x1 in equation 1. Since all the terms of the equation number first on the right side except the second term contains the product term as x minus x1. All the terms in the equation number first except the second term includes the bracket x minus x1 in the product form. Hence if we substitute the value of x as x1 in this function f of x, then we get only one term non-zero and other are zero. The second term is non-zero and its value is given by y equal to, we are putting x is equal to x1. What is the image of x1 under this function here? x1 has image y1. Hence instead of y, we write here y1 is equal to f of x1 is equal to the first term is 0. If we put x is equal to x1, then first term will be a0 into x1 minus x1 into x1 minus x2 up to x1 minus xn. The first bracket of the first term is x1 minus x1 which is 0. Hence we get the second term as non-zero, which is a1 into x1 minus x0 x1 minus x2 up to x1 minus xn. Therefore we want the value of constant term, which is a1. A1 is given by f of x1 upon x1 minus x0 into x1 minus x2 up to x1 minus xn. Similarly, by continuing this way, if we put x is equal to xn in equation 1, we get the value of, if we are using x is equal to x1, we are getting the value of a1. If we use the value of x is equal to x0, we get the value of a0. Hence, if we put x is equal to xn, then we get the value of nth coefficient of the function f of x or the polynomial f of x. An is given by f of xn upon xn minus x0 into xn minus x 1 up to xn minus xn minus 2 using the values of a0, a1, an in equation number 1. What we get? Y is equal to f of x. We will get the interpolating polynomial where the values of x need not be necessarily equally spaced. Y equal to fx is, what is a0? a0 is f of x0 upon the product of n brackets x0 minus x1 into x0 minus x2 up to x0 minus xn into this product of n brackets. Space is very small, so I am writing this term initially, f of x0 into the product of n brackets is x minus x1, x minus x2 up to x minus xn plus value of a1 is f of x1 upon x1 minus x0, x1 minus x2 upon up to x1 minus xn. Using this value in second term of this polynomial, we get f of x1 into the product of n brackets x minus x0, x minus x1 up to x minus x2 up to x minus xn divided by the value of a0. The value of a1 has denominator, that is product of n brackets x1 minus x0 into x1 minus x2 up to x1 minus xn plus last term of this polynomial is f of xn into x minus x0, x minus x1, x minus xn minus x minus x1 up to x minus xn minus 1 divided by all the product of all the n terms xn minus x0, xn minus x1 up to xn minus xn minus 2. Y equal to f of x is equal to x minus x1, x minus x2, x minus xn upon x0 minus x1, x0 minus x2, x0 minus xn into f of x0 plus x minus x0 into x minus x2 up to x minus xn upon x1 minus x0, x1 minus x2, x1 minus xn into f of x1 plus x minus x0 into x minus x1 up to x minus xn minus 1 upon xn minus x0 into xn minus x1 up to xn minus xn minus 1 into f of xn. This is called Lagrange's interpolating polynomial. Let us solve this example. Find the cubic polynomial using Lagrange's interpolation formula, which fit to the following data: minus 2, minus 1, 2, 3. See, which are the values? If we prepare the table of the given data, then initial value of x is minus 2, corresponding value of y is minus 12. Value of x is minus 1 and corresponding value of y is minus 8. Value of x is 2, then y is 3. If x is 3, then y is 5. See, the difference between these two values is minus 1 minus minus plus 2 is 1. But the difference between 2 and minus 1 is 3. Hence, these values of x are not equally spaced. And we are asking to find the polynomial by using Lagrange's interpolation formula. So we consider this value as x0, x1, x2 and x3. We'll write that values as x0 is equal to minus 2, then f of x0 is minus 12, x1 is minus 1, f of x1 is minus 8, x2 is 2, f of x2 is 3, x3 is 3, f of x3 is 5. What is Lagrange's interpolation formula? Now we are given set of 4 points. Hence, by Lagrange's interpolation formula, f of x polynomial is obtained as x minus x0, x minus x1, x minus x2, x minus x3. Since we have only the values of x as x0, x1, x2, x3, so we stop to third bracket. X0 minus x1 into x0 minus x2 into x0 minus x3 into f of x0 plus x minus x0 into x minus x2 into x minus x3 upon x1 minus x0 into x1 minus x2 into x1 minus x3 into f of x1 plus x minus x0 x minus x1 x minus x3 upon x2 minus x1 x2 minus x0 x2 minus x1 x2 minus x3 into f of x2. And the last term of the polynomial is x minus x0 into x minus x1 into x minus x2 upon x3 minus x0 into x3 minus x1 into x3 minus x2 into f of x3. We know all the values of x0, x1, x2 and x3. Also f of x1, f of x0, f of x2 and f of x3. Using the given values in this polynomial, we get f of x is equal to numerator of the first term is x minus x1. X1 is minus 1, hence x plus 1. X minus x2, what is x2? 2. X minus 2. And x minus x3 will be x minus 3 upon x0 minus x1, x0 is minus 2, minus 2 minus the value of x1 is minus 1, minus minus plus 1 into minus 2 minus the value of x2 is 2 and minus 2 minus 3 into f of x0, f of x0 is minus 12 into minus 12 plus next term is x minus x0, x0 value is minus 2, hence it is x plus 2 into x minus 2 into x minus 3 upon the value of x1 is given as minus 1, minus 1 minus minus plus 2, because we want x0, x1 minus x0, x1 value is minus 1, x0 value is minus 2, minus x1 minus x0 gives minus 1 minus minus plus 2. Again, x1 minus x2 is minus 1 minus 2. X1 minus x3 is minus 1 minus 3 into f of x1. F of x1 is minus 8 plus next term is x minus x0 means x plus 2 into x minus x1. X1 value is minus 1, hence it is x plus 1 into x minus x3. X3 value is 3, x minus 3 divided by value of x2 is 2, 2 minus x2 minus x0, x0 is minus 2, so this is minus minus plus 2 into 2 plus 1 into 2 minus 3. Since the middle term is x2 minus x1, x1 is negative, hence it is minus minus plus into f of x2 value is 3 plus last term is x minus x0 means x plus 2 into x minus x1 means x plus 1 into x minus x2, x minus x2 value is 2, x minus 2 divided by x3 minus x0, the value of x3 is 3, 3 minus minus plus 2 into 3 minus minus plus 1 into 3 minus 2 into f of x3 is 5. This is what Lagrange's interpolation formula, that is the cubic polynomial. Why it is cubic? Because each term, in the numerator of each term, the total power of x will be 3. If we solve taking multiplication of each bracket, then we get power of x in 3. We can take other one more step. F of x is equal to denominator will be minus 1 into minus 4 into minus 10. This total value is minus 20 and ratio is minus 12 upon minus 20. So it will be plus 3 upon 5. Hence 3 upon 5 into x plus 1, x minus 2 into x minus 3 plus the denominator of second term is plus 1 into minus 3 into minus 4 and the numerator constant is minus 8. This is minus 12, minus 8 upon minus 12, minus 2 upon 3. Plus 2 by 3 plus next term is 2 upon 3 into x plus 2, x minus 2 into x minus 3 plus the denominator of third term is 4 into 3 into minus 1. Numerator constant is 3. So this is minus 1 upon 4. Minus 1 upon 4 into product of 3 terms, x plus 2, x plus 1 into x minus 3. In last term, the denominator constants are 3 plus 2 is 5 into 4 into 1. Numerator constant is 5. This term is 1 upon 4 into x plus 2 into x plus 1 into x minus 2. This is what the cubic polynomial fx. This is the Lagrange's interpolation formula which fit to the given data. Also we have to find f of 0. So replace x by 0 everywhere in this polynomial. F of 0 is equal to 3 upon 5 into 1 plus 0 is 1 into minus 2 into minus 3 plus 2 upon 3 into 2 into minus 2 into minus 3 minus 1 upon 4 into the first bracket will be 2 into 1 into minus 3 plus 1 upon 4 into 2 into 1 into minus 2. So after calculation we get the value as
minus 39 upon 10.